There's a lot of different risks from climate change. I did my PhD on hurricanes, my degree's in mechanical engineering, and I have a lot of experience with numerical simulations. My name is Sydney Sroka. I'm a postdoctoral impact fellow at the MIT Climate and Sustainability Consortium, and I lead the Value Chain Resilience Impact Pathway. Our job is to communicate with our industry collaborators and understand what their needs are, and then connect them with the researchers that are already excellent at doing what they do.
I'm Michael Howland. I'm an assistant professor in civil and environmental engineering here at MIT. Whereas in academia, we can often focus on sometimes overly idealized problems to be able to understand them in great detail. What MCSC is able to do is bring in also different stakeholders who are making decisions in real time. And so we proposed a research project which was focused on understanding how we can develop resilient energy systems.
I'm Marina Rakhlin, and I lead partnerships for climate and sustainability at IBM. And when we saw that there was a lot of momentum gathering around climate change research and sustainability, the idea of the consortium came out, and we're very eager to be one of the first partners to come on board.
I'm Ehsan Kianirad. I'm a manager with Catastrophe Research and Development Group at Liberty Mutual Insurance. As an insurance company, we have a particular lens of looking at every aspect of the economy and the risk associated with that. So the help that MIT is bringing to the table to facilitate conversation with companies in manufacturing, in IT, in different services, allowed us to gain very unique perspective on how different companies really think about climate risk and brainstorming innovative new technologies that many companies and the society at the end could benefit from. That was the main goal.
We started having these conversations in the abstract about what kinds of data would you need in order to help support business decisions around proactive adaptation and climate change resilience.
Whether it's monitoring and keeping track of greenhouse gas emissions, predicting crop yields, wildfires, and the impact of flooding, all of that is really captured within geospatial data. But the challenge is that there's so much of it.
And I said, well, I could put all those together onto one interactive tool.
And IBM just happened to have a technology that we've been working on leveraging our 9 petabytes of weather data that uses AI to enable modeling in the geospatial domain. So we were very happy to share that tool with Sydney and her team.
And that's how this project started.
It's really important to have these kinds of maps like Sydney and the others that MCSC are working on, because as we increase renewable energy generation to mitigate climate change, we're to some extent increasing the interactions between environmental systems and energy systems. So we need to understand all of these variable opportunities and risks, and that you can only really understand through a visual tool.
Everyone got really excited about it, and they were like, but you could add this and you could add that.
We started to provide more comments, asking for more and more layers. Information about infrastructure, geology, major highways, power stations, large point source carbon generating sources.
Climate change is such a broad challenge that it really touches essentially every single skill set that we have as a human society, from science and engineering also to economics and equity and justice.
We need to be prepared, plan for it, and make decisions to be able to absorb that risk when it happens.
So how can we both do something as individuals, but also contribute by the power organizations that we are part of to make that systemic change?
That's a lot of collaboration. And that's the only way we're going to solve climate change.